So in this topic, I'm going to discuss about static testing basics. So let's start with the topic. So first we will see the definition of static testing or static analysis. So the definition is testing of a software development artifacts without execution of this artifact is called static analysis. So there are two words which are very important. One is the artifact itself and second one is without execution. So let's try to understand this definition with respect to these two words. So first start with the artifact. So artifacts are nothing but all the documents which are generated during the software development lifecycle. Suppose you are in the requirement phase, then the output of that is a requirement. If you are in the implementation stage, then the output of implementation is code. And if you are in the testing stage, then the output of that is test design. All these documents are eligible for static testing. So any document which is produced during the software development lifecycle has to undergo static testing to check whether they are correct or the information in that is correct or not. But the only condition is they have to be tested without the execution of that particular document. For an example, if a code is ready, then we don't have to execute that code. Instead, we have to manually see all the issues which are there in that particular code, and then that will be called as static testing. So that is why the definition says testing of a software development artifact without execution of this artifact is called static analysis. Now let's try to address these two questions. So the first question is when static testing is performed, and the second question is why static testing is performed. So these two questions are related with each other. So let's first try to answer when static testing is performed. So the answer is static testing is performed well before the dynamic testing starts. So first you have to start with static testing and then you have to start with the dynamic testing. So this is the order. First is static testing and then dynamic testing. So this is what you have to remember. So we have answered this question when the static testing is performed. So it is performed before the dynamic testing starts. Now let's try to address why static testing is performed. So the answer is defect is detected early in the software development lifecycle. So if you perform static testing, you are detecting defects early. And that way you will fulfill one of the testing principle where they say if you find defect early, then it is cheaper to fix that. And that is the reason almost all the organization have this static testing process in their complete testing process, so that they find the defect early and then it will be cheaper to fix. So these two questions are answered this way. Now let's see the example of static testing. So the static testing can be performed in two ways. So the first is manual examination, where the code will be there in front of you and you have to perform the testing manually. The second one is tool driven evaluation. So there will be a code, you have to pass that code through the tool and then the tool will give you the report. So that will be called as tool driven evaluation. So now the example of manual evaluation is, or examination is, review. So any type of review you perform will come under manual examination. And when we go for tool, then that is static analysis tool. And one of the example is QAC tool. So QAC tool is used for tool driven evaluation. And now let's see the example of manual examination. Suppose you have a code in front of you like this, then you have to perform testing manually on it. Like if you see here, this indentation is not correct. As per the programming or as per the MISRA guideline, the value should come somewhere here. It should not be in the same line. So now I have to give a review comment for this code because there is a mistake in this particular code. And then I will give this comment. So this comment I will type manually, that indentation is not correct. Whereas when you are in the tool driven evaluation, so you will have a tool here. This tool could be a QAC tool. Then you will pass this code through this tool. And then this tool will give you an output. So this will be a auto generated output by the tool itself, and tool will tell indentation is not correct. And this tool will also provide you many other information, like in which line this indentation problem is there. So it will point to this particular line, like 1, 2, 3. So in the third line, the indentation is not correct. So that way this tool will be giving you more precise report. So this is it from the example of static testing. So I will see you with my next video. Until then, happy testing.